were all those fuzzies. My mama told me all about those fuzzies. You could tell how bad they were just about how my mama and Aunt Maddie said the word. Fuzzies. Derision and venom dripping off every syllable. Sometimes I wondered how they knew when a woman was a fuzzy. One time I saw my mama fly into the living room. I thought she must have had some kind of special radar or a pair of those x-ray sticks you see in the back of a comic book. Anyways, like I said, she flew right in and lickety-split tore that channel dial right off our view to us, color TV. We had to use pliers to change the channel after that. Seems the lady on the TV, Misty Gaynor, who must have been some sort of evil she-witch. Maybe she was a hoozy times 10. Well, Mama told my daddy that she better not catch him watching that filth again. A naked woman throwing herself around the stage for everybody to see. And she said my daddy had a thick, filthy mind just to watch it. I couldn't see that she was naked. She was wearing what looked like a bathing suit with long, sparkly fringe. But now that I was looking, she was showing off some long legs. And I liked seeing her dance, but I never told my mama. And as for daddy, here I thought he was the best man in the world. Could he have evil thoughts? It made me uneasy, son. My daddy and I were very close. I felt like I just found out some nasty secret about him. And it made me scared, confused, a little bit sick to my stomach. But daddy was somebody I thought I could trust through and through. So I put those uneasy feelings back in a box and stored them way back in my memory closet. Now I was used to Mama being in one of her rooms. Even the neighbors knew, because when they heard her yelling, they would sit and laugh and ask if she was on the warpath that day. Sitting on those neighbors' steps was one of the safest places to be in those days. Because if she found us before she could ride into my daddy, she would unleash her fury on us. And that would most always meant her shaking the dust out of us at worst. But she never shook us in front of the neighbors. On those days, my sisters and me, and sometimes even Reddy, called her by her middle name, Agnes, a name she hated. Or as me and my sisters whispered, Agnes, or even Nagass, but we were sure careful she never heard us. Those were the times when you best not be seen, but if you were, you kept your mouth shut and did exactly what you were told, hoping her anger would fix on somebody else first. And I learned more slowly that if a woman wore her skirt too short or too tight, or her blouse was low and you could see that line in the middle of her chest, that she was wicked. And if she dyed her hair blonde, well, she was going straight to hell. No pass or go, no $200. But by about older, I found out why these wicked hoosies were hated and dangerous. Anyone around my daddy was a target for my mother's wrath. They were all out to steal her man. I could hear my mom and aunts whispering about hoosies who were running around with different men, married men. And worst of all, several of these men were my uncles. That made almost all of them equal to hoosies. Maybe worse, spending time and money on them instead of their wife and babies. These were not the uncles I knew. Those uncles bounced me on their knees when I was little, and they let me sit in the middle of their homebrew behind the camper when they were hiding from their wives. Well, as it turned out, I had some other aunts who were hoosies. They would strut into a room in their snazzy knee dresses and spike heels, fire engine red lips and tinseled eyebrows, all in the sweet perfume. You could smell it across the room. I could not take my eyes off them. They looked beautiful, like some kind of movie star. Not plain like my mama and my aunts. Oh yes, they would just bounce right into a room like they owned it, not caring one whit that my aunts were shooting them the stink eye. My uncle stared at the floor the whole time because no decent man was going to look at a hoosie when their wife was in the room. When the hoosies came in, it was like everything else stopped. It was like they were in a spotlight, like those plays we sometimes saw at school. They were the focus of attention, and taking no heed at all of the jealous needles of hate being shot at them from all of the God-fearing ladies in the room. Sometimes they had a passel of children in tow, dressed in ratty hand-me-downs, with tangled hair and worn-out shoes. That really got my mama and my aunts riled up, because taking care of your children should always come first. Who knows if those little ones have even been fed? And the children kicked and pinched each other, and sometimes they came after us. But our mamas could have stopped to that right fast. I like sticking close to my mama when the husband and the main dirty children visited. Mama would try for us something fierce then. Plus we knew we would not be the hot seat for her fury that day. Those times it was safe to be around Mama. Usually the husbands would freeze on out of the house as soon as they'd gotten whatever they'd come for. Usually we'd run some money out of my soft-hearted grandma. We knew how lucky we were when we visited my grandma. While we didn't have much compared to my friends in school, Grandma was dirt poor. She had to cook on a wood stove, and the coal furnace in the living room was the only other heat in the house. If you sat too long, you burned up. And if you sat too far, you froze. If you sat too close, you burned up. And if you sat too far away, you froze. My sisters and with me were just pushing each other to sit on the floor where the temperature was just right. It was a tight squeeze. Even though my mama's mama was poor, she gave away almost everything she had to the families, my good-for-nothing uncles, often going without food and medicine for her rheumatism. Since she could not say no to the worst of them, but she let the ones who were good to go without. I never had a clue where the Huzzies came from or where they lived. We never visited, and I never wondered why. Sometimes the Huzzies' sisters would come by, and even they hated them. Seemed like jealousy could get worse the closer you got to somebody. It made no sense to me, but there it was.